Good morning to our chief guest, Ms. Patricia Matthias, members of the management, parents, well-wishers, alumni, and our very own Carmelite family, staff, and students. This pandemic has tested our patience and tolerance. It has also shown how resilient we are. We find ourselves returning to the adage, we cannot direct the wind, but we can adjust the sails. So here we are at the virtual investiture ceremony of the Student Council 2020. Lead kindly light amidst the encircling gloom. Lead thou us on. We shall now have a humble offering of prayer as we look up to our Heavenly Father, the fountain of all wisdom, for His infinite grace and blessings. Let us glorify His unseen presence in our midst this morning. We have the Bible reading by Dr. Charmaine Jerome, our Vice Principal, followed by a prayer by Dr. Sister Sajita, our Campus Administrator. The Catholic Students Association will join in the worship by singing the hymn, Beautiful Lord.
A reading from the Holy Bible, Proverbs chapter 4, verses 20 to 26. My child, be attentive to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them escape from your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them, and healing to all their flesh. Keep your heart with all vigilance, for from it flow the springs of life. Put away from you crooked speech, and put devious talk far from you. Let your eyes look directly forwards, and your gaze be straight before you. Keep straight the path of your feet, and all your ways will be sure. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us bow our head in prayer. Gracious and benevolent Lord, we come into your presence on this Investiture Day with heart full of praise and thanksgiving for the marvelous way you have guided and guided our institution as the apple of your eye. Lord, continue to flow your blessings on our principal, manager, the chief guest, staff, students, parents, well-wishers, all those who are associated with us, and very specially the stars of today, who shoulders the responsibility during this pandemic year 2021. Lord, give them the wisdom to listen to your word, to be attuned to the whispering voice of their conscience. May they be placed very close to your heart. May they be vigilant. Keep their path straight. May your ever watchful gaze be always upon them as they execute various activities online. Grant all of us good health and lasting peace. May our foundress, Mother Teresa of St. Rose of Lima, and our patroness, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, be our light and hope as we journey steadily through these days of uncertainty. We make this prayer through Jesus Christ, our Master and Director. Amen.
Beautiful Lord, wonderful Savior, I'm for sure. All of my days are held in your hand, lifted into your perfect plan.
Look at your light, your holy calling, set me apart. I know you're drawing me to yourself. Lead me on, I pray. Take me, mold me, use me, fill me. I give my life to the potter's hand. Call me, guide me, lead me on beside me. I give my life to the potter's hand.
We now have the college song. Over to the Western Music Association.
May they leave us never. Shouts of the blessings, Our Lady of Carmel. May the years bring her renown on the chimney crown. Amen to that bread, amen to that bread.
Great people are ordinary people with extraordinary determination. Dr. Sister Arpana, our principal, who is a driving force from behind, will now address us.
If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, then you are a leader, says John Adams. Today marks the unique celebration of our traditional annual feature on a virtual platform. And this reflects the Carmel spirit that no matter what the challenges are, together we shall overcome. Carmel will shine. Good morning and a warm welcome to a momentous program that marks a significant beginning to the new academic year. After a rigorous and democratic process, Team 2020 has emerged by the Carmelites, for the Carmelites, and of the Carmelites. Lead with commitment, confidence, and competence. It is a defining moment for the newly elected team as they don the mantle of leadership and take the oath of office with a promise to carry out their duties with uprightness, faith, and excellence, especially during this global pandemic. A French philosopher describes three categories of people who climb a difficult mountain peak. First, the pessimist, the ones who give up easily. They regret having ventured to undertake the arduous task of climbing the huge mountain. Second, the hedonist, the ones who remain passive and just enjoy. They are satisfied with just some scenic views on the way and cease the journey with simple trifles, unwilling to take the risk to go ahead. Third, the enthusiast, the ones who seek to conquer the mountains. They are the real mountaineers who keep their eyes fixed on the peak and never give up till they reach their goal. Dear students, as newly elected leaders, you need to introspect and identify the category of mountain climbers that you would like to emulate as you take on the challenges that come your way. You are called to create strategies for success and distinction and to inspire and engage your peers to collectively work towards bringing glory to our institution. At this juncture, I express my hearty congratulations to you, dear students, the student union, the association secretaries, and the class prefects. Always remember, with position comes responsibility towards yourself, the college, your peers, and the society. I urge you, dear students, to honor the responsibility and trust bestowed upon you and become a role model in keeping with the vision and mission of Mount Carmel College. I encourage you to be committed to important issues and always remember that leadership comes with integrity. Pray not for a lighter load, but strong shoulders. The college report gives you a glimpse of the activities, competitions, fests, high on energy and novelty, lined up for you, dear Carmelites, even during these unprecedented and difficult times. So, you, my dear students, keep your eyes fixed on the peak and never give up till you reach your goal. I encourage you to strike a perfect balance between academics and extracurricular activities, and I wish you the very best and a wonderful and fruitful year ahead. God bless. Thank you.
There's no darkness so dense, so menacing, or so difficult that it cannot be overcome by light. God is light, and in Him there is no darkness at all. We now have the symbolic lighting of the lamp, as one lamp can light a whole array of lamps. Dear sisters, light the fire on the inside. You have the seed of the Almighty. Sister Bina, our local manager, Dr. Sister Genevieve, our former principal, Sister Iona, our finance manager, Dr. Sister Sajita, our campus administrator, Sister Tracy and Dr. Sister Ashwini, members of the management, and finally, Dr. Sister Arpana, our principal, who will pass on the flame to our Vice Principal, Dr. Charmaine Jerome. The flame will then be passed on to our Welfare Officer, Ms. Jen C. Jones, who will then pass it on to our newly elected Student Council members. Ms. Ruthu M. Bhatt, the President of the Student Union. Ms. Amrita Singh, the Vice President. Ms. Pruthi Ettirajulu, the General Secretary. Ms. Golla Aishwarya Sharon, the Cultural Secretary. Ms. Ayman Chowdhury, the Assistant Cultural Secretary. Ms. Anjali Ansi, the Treasurer. And to Ms. Rashmika Rajan, the Sports Secretary. Congratulations to our new Student Council, the torchbearers of all the values Mount Carmel stands for. Now they will be formally inducted. Ms. Ruthu M. Bhatt, the President.
Invest Ruthu, as President of the Union 2020-21, as she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledges to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As president of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Rutu M. Bhatt, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for the student community, encouraging such programs as will assist their overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So God, help me.
Amrita Singh, the Vice President.
I invest Amrita as Vice President of the Union 2020-21 as she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledges to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As Vice President of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Amrita Singh, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for the student community, encouraging such programs as will assist their overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So help me, God.
Spurti Ettirajulu, General Secretary.
I invest Spurti as General Secretary of the Union 2020-21 as she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledges to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As General Secretary of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Spurti Ettirajulu, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for the student community, encouraging such programs as will assist their overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So help me.
Ms. Golla Aishwarya Sharon, the Cultural Secretary.
I invest Aishwarya as Cultural Secretary of the Union 2020-21. As she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledges to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As Cultural Secretary of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Aishwarya Sharon, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for the student community, encouraging programs as will assist in their overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So help me, God.
Ayman Chowdhury, Assistant Cultural Secretary.
I invest Ayman as Assistant Cultural Secretary of the Union 2020-21 as she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledges to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As Assistant Cultural Secretary of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Ayman Chowdhury, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for student community, encouraging such programs as will assist the overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So help me, God.
Anjali Ansi, the Treasurer.
I invest Anjali as Treasurer of the Union 2020-21 as she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledges to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As Treasurer of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Anjali Ansi, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for the student community, encouraging such programs as will assist their overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So help me God.
Ms. Rashmika Rajan, the Sports Secretary.
I invest Rashmika as Sports Secretary of the Union 2020-21 as she officially dons the mantle of leadership and pledge to dispense her duties to the best of her ability.
As Sports Secretary of Mount Carmel College Student Government, I, Rashmika Rajan, do solemnly promise that I will sincerely work for the student community, encouraging such programs as will assist their overall development and train them to be good citizens. I will conduct myself in a manner worthy of my college, upholding its aims, ideals, and traditions. So help me God.
Congratulations to all of you and all the best.
All the best to our student council members as they step into an exciting, trying, and exceptional year. It's not the wins that matter, but the journey itself. It's time to congratulate and felicitate our student union 2020-2021.
On behalf of the principal and the management, I'd like to congratulate the team of student welfare officers headed by Ms. Jensi Jokes and ably assisted by Ms. Haseen Muawi, Ms. Sophia Sharon, Dr. Pavitra Raj, Ms. Premalata, and Ms. Nikita Jain. I'd like to also congratulate the newly elected Student Government 2020. We wish you the very best for a promising year ahead. Thank you and God bless.
Congratulations and welcome to the Student Union 2020-21. Indeed, in these times of crisis and challenges, leaderships get shaped. So I do wish and hope that all of you out there who are a part of the new student union use this challenging crisis situation as a USP and make a difference to the student community at Mount Carmel College. Remember, this is a unique opportunity that you have got, not only to make a difference to your institution, but also to reach out to the society at large and make an impact for yourself and for your college. So wishing you the very best. Thank you.
To you all on your appointment to lead the student union for the upcoming year. I'm sure you have the passion to lead and make a positive change on campus. The expectations are high, but remember, you're not alone. You can count on all our support and guidance. All the best.
Government 2020-21. Congratulations. Being great and no great work can be done without sacrifice. Said by Swami Vivekananda. Leadership and responsibility are the two major pillars for a student government is expected. What it means is, when it is put into practice, then only it gets the meaning. I do agree, in the pandemic situation, people have taken up the job, you have the leadership and you have the responsibility, and also choosing the classes, managing the schedule, to creating opportunity for and identifying the events and the role of the student government to take forward, for which all these years the student government has done, you have learned and you know the role very well. All the very best for the coming year, even though it is a COVID-19 period. I wish all the student union the very best. Stay safe and take care. Thank you.
Student Government 2020 is facing unique challenges. May God lead you all to make wise decisions. Good luck.
All the best, girls. I'm sure you will be remembered always as a student council who fought against all odds and emerged victorious. Do remember, we are always there with you for handholding. All the best.
Congratulations to the 7 chosen women. We understand the situation is quite unlikely, but there's a lot of room to more creativity, use technology to its fullest, and we know y'all can come up with things that MCC has never seen before. At the same time, realize that with great power comes great responsibility. Stay together. Once again, best of luck.
Hello guys, congratulations. You all will have your own sets of ups and downs, but make sure you all come out of it as a family and you all stick together and everything will be a huge success. So all the very best and you all will do great.
Hi you guys, I hope you all are doing well. I just wanted to wish you a hearty congratulations and best of luck for the year to come. I know you all will do a great job. Just never forget who you are. And if you're ever low, remember why you started. Okay, be optimistic and have faith and hope that everything will go fine. We're all here if you need anything. Much love again, and cheers to your new year.
Congratulations, y'all, and all the very best with this new milestone in each one of your lives. I know this year has not been in our favor, but I'm sure you guys are going to make the best out of it. Always remember, we're right here for y'all, and sending lots of love, all the very best.
Hey guys, first of all, hearty congratulations, and I am so proud of you. Finally, the day has come when you are the new council of Mount Carmel College 2020-2021. Whew, this journey is going to be an amazing one. It will have its own ups and downs, but remember, this is that one experience that you are going to cherish for the rest of your life. The seven members with you are going to be your new addition to your family. You're going to cry with them, laugh with them, learn things together. But just remember one thing, just stay together. Once my other study had told me that work hard for the ones who voted for you and double the efforts of the ones who didn't. So with that, I just want to say to all of y'all that all the very best and sending you loads of love. Congratulations once again.
Hi ladies, so the time to take the training wheels off is finally here. Student Government of 2020, this is me wishing y'all all the very best for the year ahead.
Guys, congratulations to all of you. Make MCC proud. Stay together, stay happy. Good luck.
As you initiate a year with many an obstacle.
And congratulations to you before you begin your chronicle.
To Iman, Ritu, Spurti and Anjali.
And to Amrita, Aishwarya and of course Rashmika.
May your year be filled with zeal and positivity.
And your endeavors be received by joy and verity.
Our ever healthy competition has been the core of our cheer.
Here's hoping to see the same yet for another year.
To the entire family of Mount Carmel College.
May your year be filled with love and knowledge.
As you take up your responsibilities and head to conquest.
We at SJCC wish you the very best.
The very best to the ladies of the MCC Union. We all know that you will have a beautiful, spectacular year ahead, even in these extraordinary times. And so from SJC and from me, all the very best. God bless you all.
Hey MCC, this is Aditi, Cultural Secretary at St. Joseph's College. My hearty congratulations to the whole student government and on behalf of Joseph's as well as the council. I wish you all the very best for the year.
Hey guys, I'm Ainsley, the General Secretary of St. Joseph's College. Congratulations girls, I hope you guys have the best year ahead. I know it's gonna be hard, but remember that we're all in this together and we're gonna rock it.
Hey, this is Preetal, the Assistant Cultural Secretary at SJC, and on behalf of the Josephite family, I wish the entire Mount Carmel Student Union the best of luck for the year.
Hey girls, Suraj here, one of the Assistant Cultural Secretaries of St. Joseph's College, here to congratulate you guys for making it to the Council of MCC. It only goes upwards from here, and I can't wait to meet you guys and hopefully collaborate on something that excites both of us. See you then.
Hey, Ralph here. I'm the sports sec of the SJC Council. We have a challenging year ahead of us, but I wish you guys at the MCC Council all the very best.
The proposed activities for the year 2020-2021 will be presented by Ms. Golla Aishwarya Sharon, the Cultural Secretary, and Ms. Ayman Chowdhury, our Assistant Cultural Secretary.
A very good morning to everyone present here. We, the cultural coordinators for the year 2020-2021, Aishwarya Sharan and Ayman Chowdhury, are here to unravel the plan of action for this year.
Let's switch things up. This is how we got our story in. No longer are we worrying. You see us rapper in the end. We see the future pouring in. It's pouring and pouring and take this DeLorean. I'm flying high, that's what you saw me. My future's up on the screen. Auditorium never looked to the best like an historian. Told us to switch it up, be different. Told us to switch it up, be different. So Carmelites, presenting to you the plan of action for the year 2020 to 2021.
Under commerce, we have Commerce Association, Business Management Association.
Under Humanities, we have
Humanities Association, Communication Club,
Economics Association, Artha,
the Literary Association, History Association, Journalism Association, Political Science Association, Psychology Association, Sociology Association, Socius, Department of Travel and Tourism,
MCC Policy Forum. Under Languages, we have
Kerwani, the Sanskrit Association, Hindi Association, German Association, French Association.
Under Science, we have Science Association, Biotechnology Association, Botany Association, Prakriti, Chemistry Association, Electronics Association, Environmental Science Association, Eco Club, Mathematics Association, Microzone Association, Physics Association, Statistics Association, Zoology Association, Home Science Association, Nutrition and Dietetics Association, Human Development Association, Interior Design and Management Association, Fashion and Apparel Design Association, BEd Association. Under Performing Associations, we have Christian Students Association, Fine Arts Association, Film Club, Indian Dance Association, Team Samriddhi, Indian Music Association, Moksha, Kannada Sangha, National Cadet Corps, National Service Scheme, Placement Cell, MCCIIE, Public Speaking Association, Quiz Association, Sports Association, Dramatics Association, Street Dance Association, Western Dance Association, Western Music Association, Rock Band Association, Real Run Productions, OSNAP, the Photography Association, MCC Toastmasters Club, MCC Model United Nations Society, Women's Cell, Rotaract Club, Fashion Association, International Students Association, Equal Opportunity Cell, Institutional Social Responsibility Cell. Congratulations to all the secretaries.
Congratulations, Carmelites. We've been awarded All India First Position by India Today for the highest number of associations.
Our guest speaker for today, Ms. Patricia Mathias, is the head of Asia Venture Philanthropy Network since April 2020 and is leading the creation of a network of female philanthropists as part of a Gates Foundation grant. Prior to this, she was the CEO of Magic Bus Singapore and Southeast Asia for 4 years, which is a charity that helps take children out of poverty. She also set up the local operations for Magic Bus at Myanmar. Ms. Patricia also has a professional experience at Procter & Gamble for 20 years, where she held the role of marketing and leadership. Who better can address us today, as she is an alumni of Mount Carmel College and the president of student government 1992-93. She graduated as a rank holder from Bangalore University and did her MBA from XLRI Jamshedpur. Over to ma'am.
Respected sister principal, teachers, staff, students, and the bright-eyed, newly minted, newly elected members of the student union. Congratulations, and thank you for inviting me to be part of your investiture ceremony. You make me feel very honored, and at the same time, rather old. In my heart, it feels like only yesterday, but I realize it's been 28 years since I wore the white sari, walked into the audi and up the stage to take the oath, and had a sash draped on me that said, President. Today, 28 years later, it feels both nostalgic and heartwarming to be here with all of you, even though I'm joining virtually from Singapore. I was asked to talk to you about leadership. Now that's a vast topic. And I realize that it is easy enough to open the computer and listen to commencement addresses by various world leaders, view TED Talks galore on the topic, and if you're really interested, you can sign up for seminars and webinars. So what can I really share with you today? I delved into my past experiences, as well as what I think will be relevant for you all going forward, and distilled a few thoughts on different facets of leadership. So first of all, let me share with you my own learnings from my own personal journey. I have learned the importance of leading with purpose. It was most obviously apparent when I led a charity called Magic Bus in Southeast Asia. The noble purpose of helping children come out of the cycle of poverty was so strong that it drove all of us in the organization and helped us overcome all kinds of odds as we established the Magic Bus program in Myanmar, Burma, and enrolled more than 5,000 children over the last few years. And help them on their journey out of poverty. Purpose can be very powerful. I've also learned the importance of working empathetically and professionally with diverse people. My 20 years working with Procter & Gamble, living in Singapore, China, Malaysia, and leading businesses across Asia, taught me the value of collaboration, of respecting the knowledge that different people bring to the table, and standing by your principles. As that is actually what people, however diverse they are, respect the most. And even as a student union in 92-93, I learned the power of rallying the student body and making things happen. I recall one of the first things we agreed as we formed the student union in 92 was that we wanted to host a Cull Fest in MCC. It wasn't something that was permitted at the time, at least for years before us, and we just wanted to change that. And though all the reasons of why it would be difficult were real, Kala was born. And 25 years later, I realized that Kala is a legacy, a batch identity. But it started with a few girls with a dream in that union room on a breezy Bangalore afternoon. Net looking back at the past 25 years, I believe every experience is valuable. Leadership is hard work. And I encourage you to embrace new and diverse experiences, as when you move out of where you're comfortable, that's when you grow the most.
The second thought I want to leave with you is something relevant to all of you being women and studying in an all-girls college. It is now publicly recognized that there is need for more women in leadership. And this is relevant not only to those in the union, it is relevant to every one of you, wherever you are. In a family, in a company, in academics, in politics, it doesn't matter where you might choose to be. Each and every one of you is called to be a leader. There is so much data now. A recent study surveyed 22,000 companies across 91 countries and found that a profitable firm where at least 30% leaders are women could expect to add more than 15% boost to its profitability. Unfortunately, the fact is that of the 500 largest companies in the world today, only 10% of senior executives are women. The opportunity awaits you. There is a need for more women leaders. So be brave, don't shrink. Raise your hand and stand up to be counted. And while you do that, please also look around you and try to help another girl in need. We women must help other women. Do you know how many girls are currently not in either education or employment or training? And this is as per the United Nations SDG Progress Report. It's a whopping 58%. More than one out of two girls in South Asia don't get an education, don't have a job, and are not in any kind of training. It is time to recognize how privileged you are. You have the opportunity to an MCC education. You have families that support you to get your degree. Pay that forward by supporting one other girl. Support her education. And when possible, support her livelihood. Find her a job. But most importantly, you can support other women by inspiring them. Inspire. Inspire other girls by the example you set. And finally, I want to address something that is going to be unique to you, and that is leadership through crisis. It has been an extremely surreal year, and I cannot start to imagine what it might be like to be a student during a global pandemic. And you are surrounded by more questions than answers, and fear. You will know people who are fearful of losing jobs, fearing what might happen to the economy. Why, the virus instills fear in all of us, to life itself. But like with all crises, there are bound to be opportunities. The lockdowns are a time to reflect, time to relook at how we operate, to reimagine the world we want to live in. And this is the time that people like you need to lead. Start by countering fear and falsehoods by actively seeking the truth. Leverage technology and create opportunities. Draw new lines and innovate. Move from being a job seeker to starting up something and creating jobs for many others. And most importantly, model how we can all be kinder to one another and to our planet. You owe it to the grouchy, frustrated, panicked, and even angry older people and an incredibly polarized world to provide hope. You have got to be our hope. So dream big, girls. Seek opportunities that will help you hone your leadership skills. Break that glass ceiling as a woman and turn the darn COVID crisis into an opportunity. Thank you once again. And let me close with lyrics from a Pink Floyd song. Remember when you were young, you shone like the sun. Shine on, you crazy diamond. You were caught in the crossfire of childhood and stardom, blown on the steel breeze. Come on, you stranger, you legend, you martyr, and shine. Shine on, you crazy diamond. Thank you.
When love and skill work together, expect a masterpiece. Just sit back and enjoy this masterpiece put together by our performing associations.
Oh, 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 oh. Varisu kannada dindimava, o Karnataka hriday shiva. Varisu kannada dindimava, o
ಮಾತೃಭಾಷೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಕನ್ನಡ ಕಸ್ತೂರಿ ಕನ್ನಡ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದರೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ನಾಡಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಬೇಕು ಬೆಟ್ಟಿದರೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮಣ್ಣ ಬೆಟ್ಟಬೇಕು ಬದುಕಿದು ಜಟಕ ಬಂಡಿ ಇದು ವಿಧಿಯೋಡಿಸುವ ಬಂಡಿ ಬದುಕಿದು ಜಟಕ ಬಂಡಿ ವಿಧಿ ಗುರಿ ತೋರಿಸುವ ಬಂಡಿ ವಿಧಿ ಗುರಿ ತೋರಿಸುವ ಬಂಡಿ ವಿಧಿ ಗುರಿ ತೋರಿಸುವ ಬಂಡಿ
Dum dum dararum, dum dararum,
To say thank you to all who have helped in giving today's program its shape and final perspective. I call upon our president, Ms. Ruthu Bhatt, to propose the vote of thanks.
They say that gratefulness is the root of all joy. So I'd like to conclude one of the most joyous days of our life by thanking Ms. Patricia Mathias for taking time out of her busy schedule and joining us today. Your words really inspired us, ma'am. I would also like to thank Sister Bina, local manager of Mount Carmel Group of Institutions and principal of Mount Carmel Central School, our principal, Dr. Sister Arpana, and our vice principal, Dr. Charmaine Jerome, for their constant guidance. I also extend my heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Sister Genevieve, former principal and administrator of Mount Carmel PU College, Sister Iona, our finance officer, our campus administrators, Dr. Sister Sajita and Dr. Lekha George, our members of management, academic deans and faculty members. I would also like to thank our admin and support staff for all the effort they have put into making this day possible. I would also like to thank our welfare teachers for being our constant pillars of support. Last but not the least, I would like to thank my fellow Carmelites, for this day would not be possible without your love and support. Looking forward to our eventful year ahead. Thank you. Have a wonderful day ahead and stay safe.
Before I sign off, a special word of thanks to Ms. Jency Jose, our welfare officer, for the professional and fabulous coordination of the whole program. You did an incredible job and your work was nothing short of superb. Thank you all and God bless.